One of my favorite quotes from Dr. Arnold O. Beckman is, "Only by taking risks do you make progress." 4 years ago, I set out to develop an instrument that could detect for the first time large numbers of proteins produced by a single neuron in the brain. The instrument I proposed would have to be more than 1,000 to 10,000 times more sensitive than what existed then. It was risky, and success was not guaranteed, but I believe the benefits to science and society would be worth it. I'm Dr. Peter Nemes, and I'm a recipient of a 2015 Beckman Young Investigator Award. This award has enabled my group to develop a single neuron proteomic analyzer, a mass spectrometer that will help neuroscientists map proteins expressed in individual neurons in the brain. There are about 100 billion neurons in the human brain. They establish complex connections to form memory, coordinate muscle movements, and many other processes. Each of these neurons produces a variety of proteins. How the protein content of one neuron differs from another remains a scientific mystery. But that information is important for understanding both normal and impaired development and diseases of the brain.
The proteins that a neuron expresses are the building blocks of its function. The proteins are what allow the neuron to conduct its particular specialized function. So in order to really understand what a single cell is doing at any particular time, you need to know the protein components. And Peter's technology is the first to be put together that allows us this at the single cell level.
So Peter's work is really important because before this, we could only look at single regions of the brain, and we could look at what was going on the protein level in hundreds or thousands of neurons. Now, with the techniques that Peter has developed, we can look at protein expression in a single neuron. That's a huge improvement.
When I began this work, we needed to combine thousands to millions of cells to create a signal intense enough for an instrument called a mass spectrometer to detect. Our challenge was to develop an instrument capable of measuring proteins from just one cell. It would take several steps. The first step was to find a way to extract the tiny amounts of protein contained in a single cell. So we developed a method we call capillary microsampling. We began with frog embryos because they are available in abundance and the cells are relatively large. We developed a method using a joystick to position a thin capillary precisely into a single cell under a microscope so we could aspirate out the specific cells destined to become neural tissue. When we published this work, it was the first time anyone had analyzed proteins from a single cell in a live embryo. We also demonstrated that this technology was scalable to smaller and smaller cells. Now that we had an effective sampling method, we had to develop an instrument to detect the tiny amounts of proteins collected. In mass spectrometry, we separate molecules, vaporize and ionize them, and fragment the ions into bits that we weigh accurately to detect the molecules. To improve sensitivity by 1,000 to 10,000 fold, we had to design and actually construct several new instruments. We first built a microanalytical platform to separate the molecules in a capillary using electrophoresis. Then we constructed several unique interfaces to ionize the molecules and guide them into the mass spectrometer. That gave us 100 times higher sensitivity, but we needed 1,000. So we developed specialized strategies to make a mass spectrometer better at detecting the trace levels of signal from a single cell. Last, we devised a way to chemically barcode the molecules so we can analyze multiple samples at one time and still know which samples came from which cells. With this method, we were able to identify about 400 different protein groups from a sample size estimating to about 1 to 3 neurons. Most recently, we made another breakthrough. We identified neurons based on their electrical activity and then detected about 300 proteins from the neuron.
This project is really opening up new avenues in measurement science, especially in a very complex chemical mixture that involves biological materials. Peter has been extremely innovative in developing these measurement strategies that involve framing his chemical questions in an extremely innovative and bold way. Obtaining funding for this kind of cutting-edge research is ex- extremely difficult because the major funding agencies tend to favor the more traditional approaches.
Without traditional funding sources available, I looked to the Arnold and Mabel Beckman Foundation because it was built on the philosophy that risks are important to innovation and necessary for breaking through barriers.
Dr. Beckman's legacy propels innovations in scientific exploration. From inventing the pH meter and DU spectrophotometer, which revolutionized chemistry and biosciences, to funding the first transistor company, which laid the path for Silicon Valley, Dr. Beckman was a visionary who led by example. His legacy pushes young scientists to think beyond what is possible today and to drive their ideas into the future.
Big picture, this is going to allow us to understand how individual cells can be functional or dysfunctional. In the case of diseases such as Alzheimer's disease or autism, or also in the case of healthy conditions, such as what exercise can do to the brain or what happens over the course of development.
All of this work has implications for a number of developmental disorders, in particular, autism, schizophrenia. In addition, my lab is particularly interested in defects that lead to hearing loss and to loss of other cranial sensory systems such as olfactory and sight and taste. And Peter's work is going to open up a whole new avenue of research in these areas.
I am deeply grateful to the Arnold and Mabel Beckman Foundation for their support over the years, which allowed my laboratory to develop and validate this prototype instrument in collaboration with several experts in biology and neuroscience. Our success has resulted in multiple awards and publications for myself, my graduate students, postdocs, and collaborators. Earlier in my career, I worked at the Beckman Institute for Advanced Science and Technology at the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign, and it was there under the guidance of Dr. Jonathan Sweetler that I came to appreciate the importance of interdisciplinary research. Dr. Beckman's life and legacy has made a significant impact on the direction of my career as a researcher and an educator. I'm hopeful that the impact of my work will carry on the spirit of Dr. Beckman's legacy.